All right, guys, standing hamstring curls, the way I do it. So if you're standing like this, straight, you might want to have something to hold on to, so we're just gonna use this. Say we're gonna use our left leg. So this is straight up, this is normal standing straight. What I'm gonna do is contract my glutes to angle my leg backwards. Right, so I just contract my glute, you can feel it squeeze here. Right, I'm just gonna angle my leg backwards. Once I'm in this position, I'm just going to contract my hamstring, right? So I'm just focused on pulling right here. Right? So pulling with my hamstring to contract. I come back down, my glute stays in this position, right? What does this do? Well, it allows us to take glute out of it. Most people will use their glute to do that, right? So if I start here and say do a hamstring curl, right? You're not going to get as good a contraction because you're not shortening this angle, right? Remember, hamstrings, of course, work across two joints, right? They're contracting here and here. So you want to maximally shorten it. So we're in this position, do this, maximally. We're contracting this joint, we're contracted here. All right, so we're contracted across both joints. The hamstring is maximally shortened. For the program, it's in the Ironman and strength training templates. I have it in there really so you get used to feeling your hamstring. A lot of endurance athletes, we have found, aren't as good at using the posterior chain and feeling their hamstring. So this is really meant to get you to feel your hamstring. If you do it right, you should be able to, the goal is almost to like try and get your hamstring to crank. Right? You should be able to squeeze it that hard, like after like 7 or 8 reps. So aim for that, and that should help you out.